All right, the almighty quadratic formula was so famous it has songs written about them. If you go on YouTube, you'll actually see some of them. There's also phrases. My favorite phrase is the negative boy couldn't decide where to go to the radical party, where the square bouncer removed four alcoholic cans, and it was all over at 2 a.m. But no matter what, any way you want to use to memorize this, you still need to memorize it. It's used very often. All right, and where it comes from is our basic quadratic. Has to be equal to zero. And the first coefficient is a, the second is b, and always include the sign, and the third is c. Okay, so now all you have to do is plug it in. So it's negative, and then the b here is negative 3. Plus or minus square root, same thing. Make sure you put everything in parentheses as you write them. So our a is 2, our c is negative 4, and then it's all over. Very important. All over 2 over 2. 2 times 2. All right, so the main complicated thing on these problems is always the radical. And so that's where you want to start. You want to take the radical and write it off to the side. And you can simplify it before you write it. So negative 3 squared is 9 minus 4 times 2 times negative 4. And this second part here, you want to multiply it all together. So I always go backwards. That's negative 8. Negative 8 times 4 would be negative 32, and then change the sign. So if you see that they have the same number of signs, an even number of signs, it's going to be plus 32. And then we add those together, and there we go. It's better because see, there's multiple steps, and if you were to keep writing, you have to keep writing everything. But this way, you just simplify the radical, and you can go on to the next part. So opposite of a negative is positive. And that's it. Now it's done. So it's nice and clean and simple if you simplify the radical first. All right, let's try another one. So the first step on this is to make it look like our nice quadratic, which means we have to set it equal to 0. So it's k squared minus 6k minus 3 equals 0. You have to subtract the 3 to the other side. And then we write our formula. And it's good to just keep writing it. That's the best way to memorize this. All right, and then we plug it in. So we're going to plug in a b, another b squared, ac, all over 2na. All right, so we need to write our a, x squared minus bx plus c. There we go, plus, everything's plus. So our a goes here, and it's 1. That's our b, and that's our c. Okay, so the b is minus 6, the a is 1, and the b is minus 3. Or the c, sorry, the c is minus 3. Let me recircle that. There we go. So one more time. B, AC, and A. Okay, we're good. So like I said before, start with the radical. So that's 36. This one will always become positive because we're squaring it. Minus 4 times 1 times negative 3. And again, negative negative will be plus, and that's 12. So that's 48. And there's our radical that we need to simplify. So 48 is made up of 4 and 12. Or we can do 6 and 8, which is probably cleaner. 2 and 3, 2 and 4, 2 and 2. All right, so we have square root of 4 twos and a 3. That's 2 and 2. That's 4 rad 3. Okay, so let's put it all back together. That's 6 plus or minus 4 radical 3 all over 2. Now, you would think it's done, just like before, but they all contain a number that's in common, which is 2, Which means we have to keep going. We need to factor out that number on top. Double check it. That's 6. That's 4. And reduce. And there you go. Now the reason we have to reduce it is it's just like any other fraction. We want the simplest form. And so if they all contain a common factor, we need to factor it out and cancel. Alright, here's the last one to try. Give it a shot. Hit pause, by the way. Alright, so you should have gotten this far. So if you plug everything in, we get this. If you notice, there's no radicals left, which means we're going to get nice, real, rational numbers. So we have to separate it and simplify. So that would give us x equals, that's 16 over 40. And then they have a 4 in common. They actually have an 8. So that would be 2 over 5. And then x equals negative 10 over 40, which is negative 1/4. So we get x equals negative 1/4 or x equals 2/5. And those are your answers. So if you can simplify it, you should. What this means is that this is actually factorable. And there's the factored form of it. So you could also have factored this instead. And this just reminded me of one thing. We're solving for y here. We can't use x. We've got to use y equals. Y equals y equals y, y. And then so on. Because we're solving for y, not x. Same thing up here. This is not an x. This is a K. And there we go. Much better. Alright, so again, if you have a radical and it's done, you don't have to simplify it, you're finished. If you have a common factor, make sure you factor out and reduce it. And if there are no radicals, that it's a nice rational number, then you must simplify it and find those rational numbers. And that's everything. That's everything for quadratics. Thanks.